building. So that's first. Secondly, when we built the North Royalton Y, no differently than we built the Warrensville Y, we had two Ys that lit up at the same time within close proximity of other operations. And over the years, we have been trying to partner both in those cities around building existing Ys, enhancing existing Ys, and we struggled for 6 to 7 years, including in Parma. We thought we had an agreement with the city went upon hard times. We were trying to get a fundraising together, didn't happen. Mayor Stefaniuk and North Royalton approached us and said, hey, listen, if we were looking at the same center at one time, which was the Avalon Event Center, if you remember, and collectively we were looking at the same thing, could we turn it into a Y? Well, as you all know, it got turned into a YMCA. And then also, we opened at the same time the Warrensville Y with the city there. So let me just clarify what happened. Both the cities came up with significant dollars. We were able to fundraise some dollars to come up with enough money to build a Y in those two different cities. That's what happened at the same time. Over the years, we've tried to watch and see what would be the impact of those Ys on existing operations. Southeast was near the Warrensville Y. This is Y is North Royalton. And there's been slow attrition of people venturing over to the North Royalton Y. There was an attrition of people going from the Southeast Y to the Warrensville Y, to the point that Warrensville was able to absorb all the membership. And last year, we eventually did not sell, we actually almost donated it to another community group that is now running it as a outreach center, from my understanding. What is it called? Community outreach center. So that's what happened in that case. In this given case, what we're not doing is we're not leaving the community. We've been trying to figure out a way for the last year, earnestly, about how could we stem continued losses at operating this facility. And as we began to look at that, we started transitioning swimming and other programs about a year ago to the North Royalton YMCA. Out of the blue, January, which we had no clue about, anybody had interest in this area or this building or this land. Somebody approached us out of the blue and said, would you be interested in selling the asset? It wasn't even a consideration. We had not marketed this building. We had not approached anybody about this building or land. Someone approached us. That's literally what happened. So we went out actively marketing this building to get rid of it. We were just trying to figure out how we could make it much more successful. So whoever asked the question, we didn't look at dollar signs when we were trying to make our decisions. Nobody approached us when we started looking at how we could make this operation more effective or efficient. It just came out of the blue. A second offer came up literally 30 days later, and it just kind of like, what? It was a shock to us, but what it allowed us to do is really look at how we can really become effective. One of the things as a nonprofit is that we have to be stewards of the assets we have. It's just a fact of matter. We have to, just like we made a decision about our Southeast Quad, just like we made a decision about our Glenville, Miles, West Side, and Brooklyn Wise, all wise that we've had transitioned from over the years for a variety of operational issues, to make sure that we can be here longer than 150 years when I arrived here. It's now 162 years old as an organization. And when I arrived here, this organization was bleeding a lot of money. And in fact, if we didn't figure out a financial plan, everything would have closed. Everything would have closed when I first got here. That's how tough it was. Now, things are much, much better, but we still, as a nonprofit, got to figure out how to make sure we pay our bills, just like you do. And this is what this is about. So we're not meeting the community. was simply redefining how we're going to service this community. And we found great partners who were willing to partner with us to make sure that we continue to have strong senior services, family programming to the degree we can have, youth sports and programming. So that's what's going on. That's what's happening legitimately. No, you're going to be, I think it's left, it's across the street or around the corner for one center. So if you're only going to sit here, you're going right across by City Hall. So it's not that far away, folks. And so we have an opportunity to try to make things better for this, the entire organization. It's not just one branch we have to look at. We have to make sure that we have regional wise, we now have a regional wide within 3 miles. It's like any business, you have to make a business decision about what you can afford to continue to do. So if you want swimming at this point in time, it's 3 miles to 4 miles away down the
line.
Okay. 4.6 miles away, which is 4.6 miles away, stand corrected here. So it's within driving distance. You can get there. And that's one of the decisions we have to make. You know, if we got facilities that are close enough that we can accommodate and that we can have auxiliary services still in that community, which we're planning here, then it makes good business sense. We operate a nonprofit business. We're trying to be successful at that so we can serve not only this community, but all communities, and that we can do it successfully. And so that's all we're trying to do here, folks. Tough decisions. And the way that we're doing this, we have 3 brands of a Y. And sometimes we only remember the one, which is a building. We have 9 facility Ys in this association. We service close to 3,000 people, and they never go to a Y building. They're in schools, churches, libraries, Masons halls, all other places. So nobody sees the logo on that building. In the city of Cleveland, we serve over 800 to 900 kids annually, and they never see a Y. We do everything inside of school with them. That's called a Y program. And so when you heard Brandon and Rick saying, it's about people, programs, and services, we're trying to make sure we still provide vital services to you, and you still get your senior program in this community. Unfortunately, if you want to swim, right now, you're going to have to go to North Royalton. Until we figure out how to work with the school district and the city about food services, because we know we can get outdoor foods and we're in discussions with them for next year, so there'll be summer outdoor food program. So this is only the beginning to the new start of a while. Yes, ma'am.
Displace anyone. This branch has approximately 25 full and part-time employees.
And none of those people are going to lose their jobs unless they choose to leave.
And we'd be remiss if we didn't acknowledge Marie, who's one of our longtime volunteers.
17 years, Marie. Yeah.
Who plans to also go to the senior center.
And I apologize, I forgot.
It's okay.
And Doug, who I know a lot of you have gotten to know in the last couple years too, who we plan to have involved with the plan as well.
I have a question. I think maybe 2-3 months ago, you issued a letter saying, well, the body wasn't going to close, and in between the lines, you could read that the body was going to close, but every time you ask one of the employees, they said, no, management guaranteed that the body would be.
So here's what I said to you. An offer came out of the blue. It consolidated over the last 90 days, literally. And literally on Friday, they sent over a purchase agreement for us to review. That was acceptable. That's what happened. The building was never marketed. You never seen this building in any publication. It was up for sale. It was never on any real estate listing anywhere. And literally, one person called, and I said literally 30 days later, another person called, one group came through with an offer. Look, this is what happened. This building wasn't up for sale. And we had to market it. We had to put it out there. We had to change the real estate game.
And the staff never lied.
They never lied.
If the staff would have said that there was something on the building, they would have been commenting on something that wasn't true at the time. This building wasn't sold. There were offers on the building, and that's why we intentionally did not discuss it with members, because it could have, 2 Fridays ago, or last Friday, it could have not happened at all, and then we would have gotten on something.
But when I read the letter, and I read between the lines, I said, oh boy, the lies are going to be gone.
Okay, you're clairvoyant, that's all I can say.